After all these years of eternally suffering, he never forgot how that stone felt in his hand when it was slick with his brother's blood.
Remember.
He now realizes what the Guardian had truly meant.
Remember.
He can't outrun his brother's memory.
Remember.
That stone, wet with blood.
Cain, you there?
Sorry. I suppose I was just lost in thought. What's up, guys? Trying something new today. I'm bringing you SCP Foundation EUCLID Class Object, SCP-073, also known as Cain. SCP-073 appears to be a heavily tanned male of Arabic or Middle Eastern descent in his early 30s. He's about 185 centimeters tall and weighs 165 pounds. He has black hair and blue eyes. His arms, legs, spinal cord, and shoulder blades appear to have been replaced with artificial versions of an unknown make and metal. SCP-073 only takes notice of this when it's pointed out and states that he has no knowledge of how, why, or when these replacements took place, stating that he's had them as long as he can remember. Examination of the unidentified metal on SCP-073 has suggested that it is beryllium bronze, a metal that has been documented as being utilized by various anomalous cultures and entities. In light of this discovery, the Foundation began working to trace the origin of beryllium bronze and how it initially spread throughout the world. When prompted, SCP-073 was able to provide information that suggests that beryllium bronze originated in the Middle East, even though the exact point of origin has yet to be determined. Further research into the origin of beryllium bronze is currently ongoing. SCP-073 has a symbol engraved in his forehead, which appears to be of Sumerian origin. The symbol has yet to be translated, but when it's mentioned at all, SCP-073 becomes distressed and refuses to speak on it. SCP-073 has professed to having a photographic memory, remembering word for word all text in an 800-page dictionary that was flicked through in a minute and a half. He's also scored above average in every intelligence test. He has a highly detailed knowledge of ancient to recent events in history and most commonly spoken languages in the world, including ones that have been forgotten. SCP-073's presence is inimical to any and all life grown in soil, causing death to any such life within a 20-meter radius. Any land SCP-073 walks on and within the 20-meter radius becomes barren as all anaerobic bacteria dies, rendering the soil incapable of supporting life until new bacteria are introduced. Anything that is derived from soil-grown life, such as wood and paper, immediately rots and disintegrates upon touch by SCP-073. Further affected derivatives include anything hydroponically grown. Not only that, but violence directed towards SCP-073 reflects any damage inflicted directly back onto the attacker, although SCP-073 visibly remains unharmed. This applies to any damage directed at SCP-073. Even attempts to get tissue and blood samples have proven futile. When the procedure was attempted, personnel carrying out the action felt the sensation of whatever was applied to SCP-073, and wound up with a sample of their own blood or tissue, despite the fact that all actions were directed solely at SCP-073. Even indirect damage through a medium also results in the person perpetuating the action receiving the wounds caused. Although SCP-073 receives no actual harm from damage to its person, he has stated that he still feels pain from the action, and has politely asked researchers to abstain from anything overly harmful. SCP-073 does need to eat and drink on a regular basis, but is strictly carnivorous considering his effect on plant-based items. SCP-073 is to be kept at Site 17. In a two-room cell furnished with all non-organic furniture, items, and a bathroom. Unlike most other SCPs, he's allowed to freely wander the facility and eat in the main canteen, but a tracking device has been attached to his body and is not to be removed. SCP-073 is disallowed any contact with the surface and is not allowed outside the facility. He's also restricted from any contact with plant-based SCPs, and violence is not to be used against against SCP-073 under any circumstances. SCP-073 prefers to refer to himself as Cain, and is generally polite to everyone who speaks to him, though he has been described as cold and somewhat mechanical in his speech. With that being said, he's very helpful and enjoys aiding personnel in their daily actions, whatever they may be. In light of SCP-073's indestructible nature, photographic memory, and general will to please, High Command has deemed that all information is to be backed up on SCP-073, ensuring that it is not lost in the event of a catastrophe. While this action has been met with mixed responses, SCP-073 has agreed and sworn himself to secrecy. SCP-073 was originally found in the New York Police Department during the 1900s, having been taken in after he was found amidst the bodies of several violent gang members. SCP-073 told police members that the gang was messing with him, but became angry and attempted to kill him, resulting in their own demise. SCP-073 was incarcerated and was deemed a, quote, John Doe, when NYPD could not find any information on him. And during a routine inspection of John Doe's, SCP-073 came to the attention of the Foundation and was subsequently taken into custody. Although much of SCP-073's origin is shrouded in mystery, when information concerning SCP-076, also known as Abel, was brought to his attention for backing up, he showed familiarity with the information, but refused to add to it, despite the fact that he stated he already knew all about SCP-076. He then stated that it would be better for all parties involved if they didn't meet. It's speculated that SCP-073 and SCP-076 are based on the biblical characters Cain and Abel. In the original story, Cain, the firstborn, was a farmer, and his brother Abel was a shepherd. The brothers made sacrifices to God, each from their own produce, but God favored Abel's sacrifice over Cain's. Out of jealousy, Cain then murdered Abel. So for that, God punished Cain by condemning him to a life of wandering. We won't dive into it too deep with this video, but it's worth mentioning how SCP-076 enters bloodthirsty states where he goes on a killing rampage. He can only be stopped by death, only to reanimate from inside a coffin after some time. This could be his desire for revenge against his older brother, Cain. Further supporting this, when SCP-076 was shown the Sumerian symbol from SCP-073's forehead, he became enraged, forcing security to kill him with an explosive collar device. When he reanimated from the coffin, the scientists asked him why he became so enraged. SCP-076 responded aggressively and became hostile once again.